Hey, it's Matt and Lizzie in the morning. And did you realize that people can listen to us anytime they want?
They can?
Nonstop if they wanted to.
No.
Yeah, it's Matt and Lizzie on demand. And it starts right now.
92 Central Maine's number one hit music station. Lady Gaga, that is Paparazzi. It's Matt and, did I say Matt and Lizzie in the morning already?
Not yet. You can say now. Hi.
Too much. Yeah. Live from the Damon's Beverages Studios. Time for Lizzie's Daily.
No, I'm excited to talk about this one because as you all know, if you've been listening to the show from the top, just really quick alert, breaking news. I'd like to shout out Nicole Baker. She sent us a message via our Facebook Messenger letting us know that she has been laughing her whole way to work. So thank you, Nicole.
Thank you, Nicole.
We have done our jobs. Okay. All right. Now, if you've been listening the whole show like Nicole has, you know that I'm having this weird moment with black bears. Maybe it's because I dreamt about it last night. There's one in Lewiston. It's kind of getting closer. I'm kind of thinking this might have something to do with like my life or my purpose. What do I need to know about bears? And then I try to find this beautiful daily awe for you all. And it's about first thing that pops up, a black bear. So let's see what's up with the bears. A black bear in West Virginia was born without front legs. Okay. And I say that in a funny way because he's fine. He's doing good. He's been spotted thriving, living in the Appalachia.
Appalachia.
Okay. People say Appalachian, but it's actually pronounced Appalachia for people that are born that. Okay. Yeah. Basically walking around like a furry ninja, just like, what's up? Hunter and outdoor writer Kirk Price, who had a face-to-face encounter with this two-legged beast, called it the toughest, baddest son of a gun he's ever seen. The bear navigates like wicked hard terrain, steep terrain, like it's training for the Olympics. Like I'm watching it. There's videos, there's photos. And despite its disability, it shows no signs of being underfed or struggling. This writer guy has tracked the bear since 2018 and estimates it to be around 8 years old. When asked if traps could have caused the bear's condition, Price said, no way, Jose. It was likely born without front legs, and he's amazed by how he's overcome his odds. He can eat, he can run, he can get honey, you know what I mean? Instagram commenters obviously are having a field day. It's gone viral. People joking that the bear lost its arms in the Second Amendment battle, and others convinced it's the real Bigfoot. Either way, this bear is crushing it, proving that who needs four legs when you can own the mountains on two, just like him. I think we should name him as well. Any thoughts on that, Matt? You weren't listening.
No, I was listening.
Do you see this?
No, I was.
So,
I was.
So what's your answer?
I think honestly, when you really think about it kind of puts into perspective.
I asked what we should name the bear.
I think that honestly,
his name should be to put into perspective.
I think Fruit Punch Bell. Okay. I think Fruit Punch Bell would be a good.
Thank you.
A good name.
Gotcha. And that's your daily.
Yeah, we're pleased to be joined this morning by Kim Ramsdell and Michelle Gucher, getting ready for the annual Corey Pease Memorial Softball Tournament, which is happening in Waterville coming up this weekend. Now, of course, proceeds go into a couple different places, but I'll let you guys get into that. Michelle, if you just kind of want to start us off with the details of the tournament, what people can expect this weekend?
We're hosting the softball tournament. There's about seven teams. We're playing at the Waterville Fields, Rummels and Herlihy. It's going to start at 9 o'clock, and we're just going to play throughout the day. We're going to have a couple tables set up. We're going to have a silent auction with a variety of items. I've got some autographed Red Sox stuff.
Ooh.
I have a potential ex-WWE person sending something.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah, I've got a bunch of gift cards from random places around Augusta and Waterville, some amazing food choices like Amici's, Downtown Diner, Whippers, Red Barn, Damon's Beverage gave us something, Silver Street Tavern, Lion's Den, just a ton of stuff. Kim and her family have made a bunch of beautiful assorted gift baskets we're going to auction off.
Oh, yeah.
And then we're going to, I think we're doing a bake sale table. We're trying to get a food truck. We're just not having a lot of luck right now.
Oh, okay. We can help you out with that. Yeah. Beep, beep, beep to all of our friends that have food trucks.
Yes.
Yeah.
We'd love to have a food truck at one of the fields.
That's great.
Yeah.
And all proceeds are going to go, half's going to go to NAMI Maine Suicide Prevention Team, and the other half is a friend of Corey's who sadly passed of suicide, Renee Vachon Littlefield.
The proceeds will be going to her son, Logan.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. This is so important, and I know it's a touchy subject because it's hard, but it's reality, and it hits too many homes and too many mommies and daddies and sisters. My heart goes out to you, but I'm really glad that you're doing this to raise awareness on such an important issue that has struck our state dearly. So the tournament is in memory of Corey and his friend. Who is it? What was the Renee. Name again? Renee. Renee. Should be a beautiful day of people coming together, fellowship, community spirit. That's October 5th, the second annual Corey Pease softball tournament. Silent auction starts at 9, you said?
Starts at 9.
And of course, you don't have to be playing in the tournament to participate, especially in those auction items. And stop by, make a cash donation, whatever you can do, or just, you know, spread the word, even if you can't be there. Share the event. It's going to be beautiful weather for it. It's going to be a good day. It's October 5th, this Saturday in Waterville.
Kim, real quick, tell me a little bit about Corey.
Oh, geez. Where do I begin? Corey was an amazing light to any room he walked into. He did have a business down in downtown Augusta, 3D supplements, really catered to men that wanted to lift, even women that wanted to lift, just really into health. And he was a bright light. He'll be missed every single minute of every day. That anybody that knows him, he's touched their lives in some way.
Great. Thank you so much for sharing that love. That's October 5th. Soon, this Saturday. Go out and support everyone.
92.
Family Dental Practice of Augusta is looking to add an experienced dental hygienist to their fun, dynamic practice and team. Apply today by emailing your resume to manager@familydentalsmiles.com. That's manager@familydentalsmiles.com. Two moves, 200.
92.
Okay. 92.